the lack of pricing power in most regions of the country. So as demand picks up, is it only a matter of time that they'll get to hike prices? And does the recent developments, the likes of the Supreme Court ban on construction in various states, also impact the demand and sentiment? Excuse me. Let's pose this question or these questions to the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of one of the country's largest cement manufacturers, Mr. N. Srinivasan of India Cements. Mr. Srinivasan, so good having you. Thanks so much for joining in. Just to get the news flow out of the way first, this is Neeraj here, of course, good morning. Just to get the news flow out of the way,
yes.
Yesterday when we were speaking to Niranjan Hiranandani or some of the other developers, they mentioned that while there is a ban that the Supreme Court has levied on these three states and a union territory, it's a technical ban and it will go away because the waste management policies for some of these states are already in place. Now, I know you may not necessarily supply in a big way to all of these states, but would this be a dampener overall? And a big one at that, or do you believe the issue will get resolved?
I think this issue will get resolved. All the Supreme Court wants is that they should have a plan. So long as they submit it, I think I don't see this as a dampener at all. But it's the state should have, most of the states in India have submitted a plan. I think these three states did not do it on time. And they have time, they've been given time to do it. So I don't think that this will have any great impact.
You do not in a meaningful way supply to any of these states, I reckon, Mr. Srinivasan.
We supply a little to Maharashtra.
Okay.
But you see, what have they said? They said no new permission for new constructions, etc. It only is aimed at the building sector, not the infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Not the infra sector, which is pulling all the cement now. So I think in a very short while, they will give that waste management plan and things will be back to normal.
Okay.
I don't see it as a problem that will sustain.
Okay, fair call. Mr. Srinivasan, just a broad brush view on how the space is looking, from not just from an immediacy 3-month perspective, and we'll talk about that as well, but from a slightly longer term perspective. I think the conversations with a lot of investors and fund managers over the last 1 month seem to suggest that the whole belief of cement capacity not coming up or coming up in a phased manner over 2 years has gotten negated because a lot of capacity is coming on stream over the next 12 months, and that might put pressure on individual players and their volumes as well as pricing by and large. What would your thoughts be on this?
See, the we must understand that after 3-4 years of very slow growth in demand, this last 6 months, 9 months has seen very sharp increase in demand, and particularly demand from the infra sector and as well as private sector housing. Now, India is a large country. The fact that a few million tons more of capacity is going to come, I don't think is going to cause any great, it will not affect either the market or the prices, because there are only 7 states in which you can you have limestone for a cement plant. And on top of that, I think the fact is today, if you want to start today, even brownfield, it will take 1 year before you can get an EC clearance, so all things going well, before you can even dig the ground. So I don't know how anyone says that this has gone some. There, we are aware of what plants are coming up on stream. Most of them are getting delayed. India has a capacity close to 400 million tons, out of which a lot of it is grinding. I mean, 30, 40 million tons or more, maybe just grinding plants, where the clinker's supply is not, you know, that assured. I mean, if clinker comes to these plants, it means it is short somewhere else. So if you take the scenario today, in the West, capacity utilization is high, the North it is high, Central is very good, East is growing well. Even the South, which had a very big gap, is narrowing. Capacity utilization has gone up. Ours has gone to 80% from 66% or 67% last year. And I think it will continue to grow. So I think on balance, finally, we see there was a time in 2005 or so when the market turned. And from 2005 to 2009 or so, you had extremely good demand, free pricing. We may be on the threshold of that. Next year may be the year where you will see very strong prices also.
Wow. Mr. Srinivasan, just a small clarification. When we spoke to India Cements, I mean, I don't remember the exact timeline, but maybe 2 months ago or maybe a month and a half ago, the conversation was that capacity utilization would probably move to 70 to 75%. I heard you mention that your capacity utilization as of now has moved on to 80%, which is a very swift move up on the capacity utilization chain. What's led to this? Is it a burst of demand that has come in the areas that you cater to?
No, I don't remember the 75. I may have been a little cautious.
Okay.
But our first quarter, we operated at 80%. And I think that will go up. And in fact, in the analyst call following the first quarter results, I ventured to say that the January, March of this coming year, which will be the fourth quarter for this, we may be very close to full capacity. The reason for this is a lot of infrastructure demand, roads, dams being built, housing. So it's a combination of everything. And mind you, a lot of it is, you know, I give you an example. If you take Andhra, Telangana together, we were estimating demand as 15, 16 lakh tons last year, or even 7, 8 months ago. Now it is 26 lakh tons per month. It's a very substantial jump. And this is with Amravati not being built, that is yet to start. So the pent-up infra demand is now on stream. All clearances have been obtained, and work has started. And this is even without this consumption, you know, is even in Maharashtra, this is without the Nagpur-Bombay highway.
Hmm.
So it's, I think in all, and this is without real infra demand in the four southern states. So my assessment is, going forward, this demand growth will be sustainable, and that it's only a question of nitty-gritties of financing, etc., for some of the larger projects, and then you will see that next year, as I said, it is like 2005.
Wow. Okay. Mr. Srinivasan, just to get a better perspective here, and then I would want you to, of course, wear the industry veteran's hat and tell me about how do you see pan-India as well and not just South India, but just a small question here. Does the central balance sheet or the state balance sheet have the strength to go ahead and fund infrastructure projects in a big way in the run-up to the May 19 elections? The private balance sheets don't, and company after company has come and said that they are still on pause or a halt mode, maybe some green shoots, but largely on a halt mode as far as fresh capex go. Does the central balance sheet have the strength to do that? Because if the fisc deficit numbers recently released from April to July are to be believed, we are already stretched in the first 4 months of the current fiscal.
All I know is that they are just gobbling cement.
Okay.
Now, You take Telangana, you know, they have got this Kaleshwaram dam. The orders placed on the cement companies, not for a specific quantity, they say supply whatever you can. So I don't know where they will get the money, but that's not for me to see. In a sense that in the last 6 months, this demand has sustained. And they are finding methods to find money. So I think it will going forward. And it's not just one road project. There are so many projects that are being constructed. Private sector housing demand is there, which is picked up a lot. So it's an amalgam of all this.
Hmm.
And it is. I was in Hyderabad recently, and I spoke to some of the other producers. The feeling is, okay, now that capacity utilization is going up all around, the question is, if that is so, why are prices not moved up? I think it's only a matter of time.
You would believe come this festive season beginning, I mean, almost there, but come this festive season beginning, prices will move up?
I made a statement in our analyst call that January onwards, definitely yes. Whether it will start earlier than that, we'll see. Possible, maybe. But definitely January, March, you will see better prices, much better prices. And going forward, next year will be very good.
So, just trying to get a sense, sir, I'm not asking you to put a number here, but is there a ballpark estimate, I mean, an X percentage rise in prices that you believe could be a safe estimate?
difficult to say, except, you know, cement is a volume game. Even a very small increase in price makes a big difference.
Okay.
But the prices don't have to go up by 20, 30 rupees. At the volumes, at levels that the industry now is operating, even smaller increases will make a very big difference to the bottom line.
Okay. An industry veteran's perspective, Mr. Srinivasan. So one can understand that South is going through this metamorphosis and therefore the demand out there is very, very strong. When you speak to your peers in the rest of the country, do you sense a weak link somewhere, some pocket or some geography which may not quite have the kind of demand that the rest of the country or South India might have?
No, the rest of the country is better than South India. Mm-hmm. See, South was where you had the maximum capacity overhang. In other parts of the country, the utilization levels will be much higher. And I think, like I said, in some parts the prices are quite good. And where the prices are slightly weak, they'll catch up also. That is, and at the moment today, there is demand for clinker, which we are supplying from our Andhra plant all the way to the east. So the supply position is tightened up there. So price increases will follow.
Okay. I have one last question, sir. Something that could, if it could play a bit of a spoil sport. Any cost pressures, either due to the currency or due to petcoke or otherwise, that could poop the party a little bit?
See, the cost pressure, see, petcoke prices have gone up. Now, a lot of us have switched to U.S. coal also, you know, so that, you know, we don't have, you know, we are not sure about the government. One day says you can use it, one day Supreme Court says no, etc. So why not? U.S. coal is as good enough. Coal is as good. The sum total of all this, for example, let us say the petcoke prices, the weakening of the rupee, all this put together, okay, maybe 100 rupees a ton, which is 5 rupees a bag, just 5 rupees a bag. So I think going forward, the cost pressure can be passed on without much difficulty.
Okay, well, that's a really confident India Cements management. Mr. Srinivasan, so good having you. Thank you so much for taking the time out and giving us a broader perspective as to what could happen over the next 18 months in this space. Really appreciate your time.